Yeah, thanks for joining us on another episode of 420 Grams. We had come for the launch of the Hero I-League. 13th season of the Hero I-League is upon us. I think that's what the guy who was heading the state said. And starting on the 30th of November, we saw members of each and every team that will be taking part in the I-League come on stage and tell us a bit about themselves and, of course, the campaign and what to look forward. I'm joined on 420 Grams by partner in crime, Siddhanth Aney. And also, we're joined by Mihir Vasavda, who, of course, has been following Indian football very closely. And humne ye bhi kaha ki, dekho ji, humne itni homework kari nahi hai, to aisa na lage ki hum yahan pe aake bakwas hi kar rahe hain. To Mihir aaya hai, thoda homework karke hai, wo jante.
कुछ ज़्यादा रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी डाल रहे हो मुझ पर, होमवर्क तो मैं कभी किए ही नहीं लाइफ में.
वैसे मैं एक और बात बताना चाहता हूँ, अगर आप बाद में देखें ये स्टेज उठ रहा है, तो हमारा चैलेंज ये है कि जब तक ये स्टेज डिसमेंटल होएगा तब तक होपफुली हमने शो ख़त्म कर दिया होगा. अगर नहीं होता तो फिर जी देखी जाएगी जो होगा. सो गाइज, आई लीग स्टार्टिंग एंड मोर देन हु इज़ द फेवरेट, हु इज़ नॉट द फेवरेट, आई थिंक वी हैव टू स्टार्ट फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू कि अगर तीन साल जब तक आप बैठे हुए लीग में, चाहे जीतो हारो जो भी हो रहा है, फ्रॉम अ क्लब्स पर्सपेक्टिव आपका अप्रोच क्या होगा पैसे के हिसाब से? क्यों, धंधा है, पैसा फ्री में नहीं आता जी, और मोटा पैसा है, 2 करोड़ 3 करोड़ का बजट है. सो देन हाउ डू यू अप्रोच दैट? डू यू से आई एम गोइंग टू स्टिक विद माय 2-3 करोड़ बजट, और डू आई से लुक आई एम नॉट गोइंग एनीवेयर, सो आई विल पुट अ 1.5-1 CR टाइप ऑफ बजट एंड जस्ट रिमेंबर व्हेन दैट विंडो ओपन्स देन आई यू नो स्टार्ट पिकिंग इट अप.
आई थिंक ये लॉजिक apart from East Bengal and Mohunbagan, most clubs I assume would kind of take this step. We've seen in the last few years itself, like clubs like Shillong and Aizawl have already cut budgets despite I-League being called the top tier. So now that abhi agar jo second division officially se bula rahe, then what's the motivation for them to go on? We've already seen announcement for so many clubs, right? I mean, I think Aizawl have already said that they'll be scaling down further. The question actually is ki आप कितना और ब्लीड करना चाहोगे? इट डजन आई डोंट थिंक इट मैटर्स टू देम वेदर दे आर ब्लीडिंग 1.5 करोड़ और 2 करोड़. इट्स जस्ट कि वो लोग कितना और पैसा डालना चाह रहे हैं. एंड फॉर द फैक्ट कि नेक्स्ट 5 ईयर्स के लिए एटलीस्ट यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू बी इन टॉप डिवीजन, यू आर नॉट इवन गोइंग टू गेट अ शॉट एट द टॉप डिवीजन, डिस्पाइट नोइंग दैट कितना वो लोग पेशेंस रखते हैं टू कैरी ऑन, आई थिंक दैट इज द मेन थिंग. सो आई डोंट थिंक दे आर, आई मीन लूजिंग मनी ऑब्वियसली इज सैड, but more than that it's just ki continue karna hai. Yani is there any point in continuing in this whole exercise? Ek saal kar lenge, 2 saal kar lenge, whether we'll see change in ownerships, whether we'll see the clubs shutting down themselves, that is the main thing over the next 5 years, like for me at least.
Bhai, sorry to put, like, is the lighting gonna make a difference? So you want to change some settings or keep going?
Start. तो भाई, आई मीन एक हो गया पैसे के हिसाब से, आई थिंक इट कुड आल्सो बी अ ब्लेसिंग इन डिसगाइज, क्योंकि जहाँ हम कह रहे हैं हमारे इंडियन लड़कों को ज़्यादा खेलने को नहीं मिल रहा, अगर आपने बजट काटने हैं तो आप फॉरेनर को बिठाओ और आप अपने इंडियन लड़के भरो और इंडियन लड़कों को खिलाओ, चाहे क्वालिटी ऑफ योर लीग माइट गो डाउन, इन द लॉन्ग रन आपका लड़का एक बन रहा है कि नहीं?
आई सपोज सो यार, आई मीन अगर सेकेंड डिविजन तो जैसे हो ही गया है लाइक मीर वाज सेइंग, तो ठीक है, at least everyone knows now exactly what the scene is. If you have to move forward, what you have to do, what you have to put in now, year 1 mein aapko ye karna hai, year 2 mein ye karna hai, year 3 mein ye karna hai, and then hope that eventually, as they are saying, there will be a system of promotion relegation and there'll be inroads for some clubs to make it to the top tier, other clubs will go down, and hopefully overall, I mean at least that's what we are being told, that overall structure will be created where 30-40 clubs will be playing competitive football on a pan-India level, which is a positive. The other positives, it's a, not to do with player creation as much, but was the coming in of a new broadcast partner, which at least opens up alternative or some source of revenue through advertising, right? Before this, because of the sort of convoluted ownership structure with Star Sports having a stake in the league, that channel was sort of closed, or all the money that was coming in through the same party. Now at least with D-Sport, they'll be selling ads, and the clubs will get a share of whatever comes in. So, and going forward, if it's successful, because we know that there are fans, there is an audience for this league, right? Mohunbagan, East Bengal, even other clubs have a following. The games are watched at least as much as the ISL games. So there is scope to sort of bring in and create, if not sustain, football clubs don't make money anywhere in the world, yeah. So it's not going to be like people will keep bleeding or losing money, but that's, you don't get into, like we keep saying this, no one, you're not getting into football to make money. You make money and then you do football because you like to do football, I think.
I would slightly differ from your point where you say that because budgets kam hai to shayad Indian players ko zyada mauka milega. What we have seen generally is ki budgets kam hai to hamari quality of foreigners kam ho jati hai and they don't give an Indian players a chance. For example, in Mumbai, when we used to go for matches at Cooper Edge, the joke was ki Air India just to fill that foreign player quota, nala sopar se jaake Africans lekar aate the. So it doesn't matter if you are a footballer or not, as long as you are a foreigner, it, that's what the perception that the teams want to create. Or mujhe dar hai ki shayad ye trap mein kahin teams na phas jaye, where just to, for the sake ki, to show ki dekho hamare team mein foreigners hai, aap substandard players ko lao and not give the Indian players the opportunity they deserve.
Yeah, fair enough. And but this is a, another small positive change that I have seen, or we have seen. You might not agree, but I don't think that is the attitude anymore. With more and more Indian coaches getting into the system, club owners also looking at it as, you know, what lower league clubs are trying to do is capitalize on a transfer market, hope that some of their players do well, and then move on to a bigger club so that they get something out of the investment that they've put into that player. So there is somewhat of a model being created to incentivize clubs to get younger players, Indian players, into the scene.
You know, that's actually a very nice point. So I was talking to Ranjit Bajaj
once in a while.
And we were talking to my friends. And so then he made some good points. One, I asked him from an owner's perspective, jo apna paisa laga raha hai, आप क्या करोगे 3 साल के लिए 4 साल के लिए, कि आप बजट नीचे लाओगे कि आप उसी बजट पे आप ऑपरेट करोगे. सो यू सेड लुक, इट डिपेंड्स ऑन एज अ क्लब व्हाट योर एम्बिशन इज वंस दैट विंडो ओपन्स अप. इज योर एम्बिशन टू गो इनटू द आईएसएल? देन यू कांट सडनली डू कि चलो जी मैं डेढ़ करोड़ के बजट पर मैं 4 साल चला रहा हूँ एंड देन आई वॉन्ट टू गो टू द आईएसएल वेर अ बजट इज रिक्वायर्ड ऑफ 20 crore. देन आप बौखला जाओगे कि हाउ डू आई हैंडल दिस मनी. सो यू हैव टू बी ऑपरेटिंग ऑन अ सर्टन अमाउंट ऑफ मनी to know how to operate it, how to use it, where to use it, so you don't use it to bad use or whatever, or you misuse it in whichever which way possible. The other thing he's saying, player creation, he's saying now the focus should be on academies. So he said, uske teen ladke, Jackson, I forgot the other two names, Anwar Ali, and a couple of more who've gone into the ISL. He said, I've sold them to clubs, directly ISL clubs, and he's made a crore out of it. A crore out, which is not bad, bhai. Huh? You're making 1 crore. He said, courtesy of that 1 crore, my one batch in an academy can run for 2 years. And that then is a self-sustainable model. I think that is the way forward, yaar. I-League clubs, agar aap niche aage ho division mein, theek hai. I think aapko ab focus karna chahiye apna talent banane ke liye. And talent ko fir aage aap kaise becho taki wo paise se fir wapas aap apne club mein paisa dal chuko, taki then you're not bleeding money. Then you've sort of found a full circle kind of cycle. And you know, that in turn helps you move ahead, yeah.
Yeah, that's a great point, I think, because we've seen ये सारा जो फंडा है, we've seen कि हम रेडीमेड प्लेयर्स के लिए वन ऑफ कभी ट्रांसफर में पैसे हो गए, बट एकेडमी प्रोडक्ट्स एज सच वो कंसेप्ट तक इंडिया में आया नहीं है. वी ऑब्सेस एंड वी रोमांटिसाइज हाउ यूरोपियन क्लब्स डू इट. हम यहाँ पर बैठे बैठे संडरलैंड तक की बात कर लेते हैं, बट नो वन वॉन्ट्स दैट काइंड ऑफ एन एफर्ट और पेशेंस. एंड आई थिंक वॉट एवर पीपल से अबाउट रंजीत बजाज, वॉट एवर ओपिनियन दे होल्ड अबाउट हिम, but one thing that he's done magnificently is the academy setup. Kitne players usne nikale last few years mein, so no one can take that away from him. But again, it all comes down to intention and patience. Like Ranjit ka, whatever you say cliche agar hum baat kare, to it's the passion that keeps him alive. Do the other people have same level of passion and patience? Would they want to invest that crores of rupees year on year on something that is not sexy at all, youth development, jahan par aapko media coverage nahi milega, jahan people won't talk about you on Twitter?
Yeah, so I'm going to take off on a solid tangent for like 2 minutes. Left. Abhi hum, it's the 21st of November. परसों जो जे एन यू स्टूडेंट्स का डेमोन्स्ट्रेशन हुआ था वॉज बेस्ड ऑन द आइडिया दैट एजुकेशन शुड नॉट बी ए प्राइवेटाइज्ड एंड बी कमोडिटाइज्ड. Now, this is something that's very relevant when it comes to football education and what we are trying to create in terms of footballers, etc., etc., all this academy stuff, right? There's no argument to be made that the commodification of the sport is not complete. It is. All these guys who we see flaunting the jerseys and stuff for various clubs, they are essentially being treated as commodities, right? Traded in and out, bought, sold, whatever, whatever. I think whatever system is created, it's extremely important to also remember that we are talking about like very young children that are coming into the system. And we're not, like, why should clubs exist? Why should clubs continue to survive, thrive, grow, whatever it is that they're doing? Because it's a sort of community effort to create some kind of a feel there. Some you know, why are there fans? Because they support, they identify with something, right? The more you go into this unregulated academy system with no links to directly to clubs, you open it up to all kinds of exploitation, which, and I'm really not in favor of how things are done in Europe, because the bigger the club, the more the money, the more the scope there is to exploit kids from all over, yeah? Like you're saying, Africans from Nalasopara, or Africans from, or Nigerians from Nigeria, or wherever kids are coming from these days, right? We've seen kids at various academies from all over. I mean, as it is, within the size of this country, आप कहाँ से उठा के लेके आ रहे हैं इन बच्चों को और इनके साथ क्या हो रहा है थोड़ा इस पर फोकस होना चाहिए आई थिंक ये अगर क्लब स्ट्रक्चर सॉलिड ना रहा सब लोग एकेडमी में घुसना शुरू कर दिए तो ये वाली दिक्कत हो सकती है मेरे ख्याल से एंड दैट शुड बी अवॉइडेड द सेकंड थिंग इज सिंस यू टॉक्ड अबाउट ओनरशिप एंड वी आर दिस कॉन्वर्सेशन इज एसेंशियली अबाउट हाउ द मनी इज गोइंग टू गो अराउंड वी आर टॉकिंग टू सुनंदो अर्लियर हु इज द सीईओ ऑफ द लीग एंड He said an interesting thing that the I-League is as much an AIFF property as the ISL. Now, to my mind, and I may be wrong here, it's a question to both of you, the ISL is an FSDL property. Now, right? So it's a problematic thing. I mean, the AIFF no longer, essentially they're saying that they no longer going to retain any control. The FSDL and AIFF will be almost synonymous with each other. Is that what is coming across? It's what it seems like to me.
I think, if we want to paraphrase Sunandho, they should have said that I-League is as much a product of AIFF as ISL is of IMG Reliance, or Indian football is of IMG Reliance right now. But that whole ownership thing of Indian football has been a dicey topic for the last 10 years. I mean, we've all spoken about the contract and how it's basically sold Indian football to a private entity. My thing is that as long as the product delivers, right, it shouldn't matter kaun chala raha. As long as it's done in a fair, transparent manner, it shouldn't matter agar jo Reliance chala raha hai ya AIFF chala raha hai ya some random XYZ person, right? We've always spoken about a league being independent from a federation. We've spoken about that already a lot of times, and that's how it should be. Whether there should be a private entity, that's a totally different thing. But at least, and for decades now, we've seen that AIFF has not been able to do anything with the I-League or ISL or whatever form of leagues we've had. So, to be fair to ISL, if they are trying to do something, let's give them 10 years. Let's not judge in 5 years and say, ki chalo, ye log ye kar rahe. If they are taking ownership of Indian football, that's a problematic thing. But again, like...
Maybe it's not. Who knows?
Yeah, it's not. Maybe it's not. Like, I'm firmly of the opinion ki the national team is improving. Whether it's because of FSDL or not, it's a totally different debate. But it's happening right now, jo bhi ho raha hai wo, at a time when the ownership of Indian football is an issue. So I think from a larger context, this whole ownership of the league, whether IAFF owns I-League or FSDL owns I-League, it's just that whether it is ethically, again, we'll go back to the episode that you guys have had already about FSDL's involvement in Indian football. It goes back to an ethical issue more than that, ki whether you should surrender your rights, whether you can sell your logo, a national team logo, to a private entity. That's the problem. But as long as I think league ownership and conduct of the league goes, I don't think we can complain. I mean, ISL is, I mean, whatever their faults are, but ISL is at least done in a professional way.
Yeah.
I mean, everyone, for a reason, everyone aspires to be in ISL. So,
I guess the...
Wow.
ये आप लोगों को दिखा रहे जी काम जो होता है ना आसान नहीं होता ये देखो हमारे जो प्यारे दोस्त हैं तो लगे रहो सर लगे रहो अपने को क्या म्यूजिक चल रहा है यहाँ पे अच्छी बात है ये देखो नहीं या सो एनीवे सो दीस गाइस आर ऑन बट वी गाइस आर डिस्कशन इज ऑन एज वेल भाई आप कुछ बोल रहे थे
मैं बस इतना ही बोला था कि डिसीजन मेकिंग थोड़ा ज्यादा कोलैबोरेटिव और ट्रांसपेरेंट हो सकता है द पॉइंट दैट यू मेड आल्सो दैट लाइक ओनरशिप फेयर इनफ यू हाउएवर इट्स डन बट लाइक व्हेन यू आर मेकिंग की डिसीजंस इन टर्म्स ऑफ हाउ things are going to be structured or how things are going to move forward that process needs to be a little more inclusive is all that's all but you will say now jisne paisa lagaya usko apna pound of flesh to lena hi hai
main keh raha hu main thak gaya hu yaar ye baatein kar kar ke thak gaye hain bhai matlab kitne time se hum baatein yahi baatein kare ja rahe hain thodi aage badhe but at least the good thing is yaar thoda to kuch structure aaya hai sir jab ho bhi hoga
the national team is getting better so
yeah
Oh, God, man.
There are two cameras
oh,
here.
Oh, God.
Okay. No, I need to clarify. National team is getting better. It was getting better, but it's, I think, stagnating now. That's a different debate for a different day.
Fair enough. Fair enough. This debate is on the I-League, guys. So, what? So, how many? I think we have two teams from Imphal this time. The Imphal Derby is what we're going to be seeing. I think that is the one game I'm really looking forward to, man. Bhai, you were in Manipur. You spent a considerable amount of time with a friend of the show, Mr. Henry Singh. सर क्या है माहौल वहाँ पे त्राओ और नेरोका के बीच में
माहौल मतलब नेरोका बाय बिकमिंग द फर्स्ट आई लीग क्लब मैनेज टू गेट अ सॉलिड फैन बेस बिहाइंड देमसेल्व्स त्राओ इज एसेंशियली द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ त्राओ इज टिडिम रोड एथलेटिक यूनियन इट्स वन ऑफ सेवरल हंड्रेड्स ऑफ लोकल क्लब्स इन द एरिया इन इम्फाल इट्स ए स्मॉल क्लब विद small but passionate following like you're talking about Ranjit Bajaj again it's like mostly driven by a family who are backing it and a lot of local players so you know we in fact the Chao kid who was on here talking he talked about how his the club that he supports is the club that he grew up playing with so it's the same with these guys and you'll have a lot of local players coming into the scene So their families will come, their villages will come. Yeah, I think it'll be, and it's always great to have derby games, man. Pakka 30,000 log aayenge dekhne. Is baar under lights hoga, raat ko hoga. You know, normally, ab 7 baje shaam ke, especially winter season mein, Imphal band ho jata hai. It's like midnight there because of also the time zone. I mean, not the time zone, but the positioning. Here you'll have finally something for people to go out and do in the evening. So really looking forward to it.
By anything you're looking forward to from not from structural or ownership or kaun chala raha hai system jo ladke khel rahe hain jo aapne of course kaam kiya hai any stories to look forward to as far as the I league is concerned
I'm looking forward to two stories actually one is how East Bengal and Mohun Bagan react now for years they've been trying desperately they've pumped in kitna East Bengal I'm sure they've pumped in more than 100 200 crores right now to win the I league title एंड नहीं जीत पा रहे यार लास्ट दिन आखिरी दिन तक आए और नहीं जीत पाए वो लोग मुझे देखना है कि कितना हद तक वो लोग इस बार जाते हैं टू गेट दैट टाइटल एंड वेदर दे विल एक्चुअली जंप द शिप टू ISL बिफोर लीविंग द आई लीग टाइटल वुड दे वॉन्ट टू गो डाउन एज अ क्लब दैट नेवर वन द आई लीग तो मुझे आई एम रियली एक्साइटेड टू सी हाउ ईस्ट बंगाल एंड उसके वजह से हाउ मोहन बगान रिएक्ट टू दिस होल सिनेरियो And then, of course, I mean, I think one story that we've all fallen in love with is the real Kashmir story. So, I mean, again, we've seen ki they've had great debut season, but again, kitna repeat kar paate hai? I mean, we've seen that clubs struggle to repeat the same performance in the second season. Kashmir have had a very good pre-season. They've had a troubled pre-season as well. David Robertson is saying that it's a very close-knit group, family group. ये वो सब काफ़ी चीज़ बोल दिए उन्होंने पर आई एम वेटिंग फॉर डिसम्बर 12 जब फर्स्ट मैच वहाँ पर होगी श्रीनगर में आई एम 15,000-20,000 तो आराम से आ जाएंगे क्राउड का रिएक्शन कैसे होता है ड्यू टू द पॉलिटिकल सिचुएशन देयर how the players react. I'm really looking forward to that bit as well.
Mihir Vasavda, Siddhanth Aney, guys, thank you so much for joining us. Remember the I-League, we here on 420 are making a promise that we will cover the I-League in whichever way possible, and we'll likely do shows every week or every 2 weeks, I don't know.
And a podcast,
yeah. So that's it from us on this episode. And jate jate follow karo yaar mereko yaar. Aao. Jate jate, aapko dikhate hain I-League ki reach kya hai. Sir, is bari I-League kaun jeetega?
Sir, par isko koi pata nahi sir.
Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye.